Last time on Babs Bear Talk.
Joe thinks that's our Jeep right there, the one that we used to own that we sold. Because the people who bought it were going to renovate it completely right there. So my dad's been on a road trip to Belize. He's not the one driving, but he's the passenger. But they're not driving at nighttime at all. So, and I prefer it that way. But we've been kind of like really, not worried, but kind of a little bit stressed about making sure he arrives safely. He's going to fly back. But I don't know what's wrong with daddy. He wants to be adventurous. Anjo? He likes road trips.
Get him on, right? If you want, just, yeah, you know. Mm-hmm.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna make a new batch of sourdough starter. So I have my clean jar. This is 1 cup of regular flour, all purpose, 1 cup of filtered water. Okay, stir it with plastic, don't stir it with metal because it always goes bad for me when I stir it with metal. So let me stir this up until it's smooth. And I've shown this at my cooking channel, but I'm doing this today because I want to help out Ellen with all the little tips and tricks that I've been doing to reverse low stomach acid. Take a piece of shrink wrap and just loosely throw it there, and then I'm going to take this and put it on top of the fridge. This right here is the best sourdough bread that I get at Costco. What does it say, Joe? La Jolla. This is the best one that I can find. It's kind of pricey, like $5 or $6, I think. But it'll last us like 10 days. This is the starter that I had that I feed every week with half a cup of flour and half a cup of water. First, when I feed it, I mix it up first. And then I throw out about half of this. And I add back half a cup of flour and half a cup of water to this. But I'm not going to throw out any today because I'm not going to be feeding. I'm going to be proofing the sponge. And what I'm going to show you how to make is sourdough waffles. Again, I have this at the cooking channel already. But I'm doing this as a part of the vlog for the people who don't watch my cooking channel, okay? And then to proof it, a cup of filtered water, a cup of flour. Give this a stir and then wait for the bubbles to come. So as soon as I stir this up, I'm not gonna cover it. Just leave it right here on the counter and then see those bubbles? Can you get in on that, Joe? We wanna see more of those all over and we know it's ready, okay? All right, so like an ounce and a half of orange juice to start the morning. And I give this about a half hour to get my stomach activated. If you don't do the orange juice, you could do water with a little bit of lemon or lime in it. Now, if you feel like there's a brick in your stomach, rather than run for the laxatives, get a little bottle of Coke like this. This is how many ounces? 12 ounces. You don't even need to drink the whole thing. 6 ounces will do, and then give it about a half hour and see if it moves, okay? So this is another trick. I got this from Free Little Banana Girl. The pitted dates I get at Costco, this big old tub like this. Put about 10 or 12 dates in the blender and then put a lot of water and blend. Set for this. And I promise you, this breakfast is gonna make you feel good. Only mix however much of this you're gonna drink though, because it gets foamy like this, see? Like yogurt. Let me show you the yogurt that I use. I use this one from Costco. Kirkland brand Greek yogurt, plain non-fat, and I put it on grapes. It's still have to wait, no babe? Then people race it to the light and still have to wait for the red light just like you. So I'm bringing this with me so that I can finish it up. We're heading to Walmart so that I can get something else as a baby shower gift. And then going by the shop to pick up my 2 light bills that are due on the 29th. Today is the 24th. I want to get some pre-folded diapers for my cousin. She's not going to use cloth diapers on the baby, but she can use that as a burp rag, or if she's going to nurse, she can put it like under so she doesn't have spillage and stuff. I'm buying things that I know was helpful for me when I had my kids. I don't like to go to people's registry and go get exactly what they ask for. I mean, what is the element of surprise? Let the people bring what they want to bring, right? Joe's going to drive around back to see if Glenn, watch this baby. This is a baby. Joe, how old is this baby? Joe, Jesus. How old is this baby? Like 5? And he's gonna tell you to come too. Jesus. He's very cute. Okay, so this is my back door past these boxes. No, he didn't open it back yet. It's my back door. This is Glenn. And how are we gonna get out of here?
Toby.
Oh my god. This feels like little TJ. Does this feel like little Tijuana, Joe? Huh? This don't feel like Lee Tijuana? So this is the other side. We're in here. We used to be in the 400 series, you know, but we're in the 200 series now. Yeah, yeah. It's a beautiful day, but it's going to be 200 degrees.
Hot?
It's going to be hot. It's going to be like 112 in certain places, and the wind's going to blow. It's probably going to blow where we're going. Joe's putting in the gas now so that we don't have to stop and put it in when we leave, because all the kids are going to be with us, and it's going to be like 112 degrees, so... my aunt Jenny, even though it's a baby shower, she wanted everybody to come from the family because she wanted an opportunity to let the family get together again. You guys have been with me long enough to know that my mom was the glue that held this family together, and we just feel like wandering souls, I'm telling you. So it's gonna be nice to see everybody today. This is right at 2 hours later. See all the bubbles? So you know that this is ready. We're gonna make back the mother, and then we're gonna leave 2 cups of this behind. And to that, we're gonna add a cup of flour, 3 teaspoons of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 4 tablespoons of melted butter, 2 eggs, and 1/2 cup of milk. See, I have it here, the flour, the sugar, the butter that I'm gonna go melt in the microwave, the salt, and I've got to get the 2 eggs and the milk. So I've set the waffle iron to heat up. I just turned it on. And let me grab the eggs. Okay, guys, so to make the mother, just want to go ahead and give this a stir. This smells good, by the way. If it smells putrid, it's probably not sourdough. And try to get a full cup. And just go ahead and pour it. So that's about a cup. I'm trying to do everything and look through the camera at the same time, guys. I don't want to have to go put the camera on a stand. To this, we're going to add 1/2 cup of flour and 1/2 cup of filtered water. It's melted sufficiently. And by the way, my waffle iron is ready. So 2 cups of starter, 1 cup of all-purpose flour, 3 teaspoons of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and then, of course, the eggs. And the butter and the milk. Of course, you can mix all the wet together, okay? And then mix it in with the dry. Doesn't matter, long as you get here. So let me go ahead and stir this up into a batter. So I put some butter on with a barbecue brush. And this is 1/4 cup measurement that I am measuring with to get it perfect. Close it and wait for it to stay ready. This is the boiled eggs that Joe did. This is 2 eggs. I squished it with a fork with a little bit of salt, pepper, and butter, because that's just the way I like my boiled eggs. I don't eat any other egg with salt except for boiled eggs. I'm going to eat 2 pieces of the waffle with this. I'm going to take some grapes and the yogurt with me. That way, if they take a long time to serve the food, I have my own snack. And I don't have to go hungry, because that's one of the chief things too that you have to remember. Don't go hungry or you will start feeling that bubbly, like the gas coming up and stuff because of the low acid. So let me go put my camera to charge so that I can vlog from there, guys. Everybody's ready to go. Jada's like doing fancy thing with the gifts because I'm dumb when it comes to that. Jordan's gonna go get the best seat in the car. Joshua's getting ice. And Daddy got the poops. I am so not kidding, guys. Joe woke up with diarrhea this morning. We're heading down to the baby shower. It starts at 1. We're leaving like at 11:45. If we don't get there right at 1, we're okay, but we're gonna get there shortly after.
See, that person on the door. See, Josh, you told me this
and,
is car washing, but it's not. No, it's
my my Aunt Jenny already called to make sure we're coming. So she's looking forward to seeing us. Under the canopy?
That's what I think. I mean, I see bags like that.
This is a nice park, though.
See Money Cowboy.
You see Chapada already? Joe calls Monica Chapada. Means shorty.
They got right.
We have to walk in this grass, though? I didn't bring the right shoes for this grass. I sure did not bring the right shoes. Yeah, walk with me around the grass that we could cut straight across. So I totally should not be vlogging. Walk on this grass. And see, my handsome son's just holding on. So look at the beautiful decorations. These are my children, in case anybody didn't know.
Alright, we just
had a homosexual because of the people.
Huh?
With the white.
Ah, no,
we're good.
This is my cell.
Okay. Yeah, thank you. I don't know what she's doing over there.
That was the rules, as long as you're a part of your family.
You did, yep.
That's true.
I love it.
So my Aunt Jenny's feeding us, who are here first, because she said the latecomers, see it's 2 o'clock. We're not going to wait for them. Let's take a look at the table. Oh, look at her name. Sophia. It's a girl. So I guess none of the games are going to have us guessing if the baby's a girl or a boy. Look at the cake.
Oh, I just saw that.
None of the games are going to involve us guessing her name, I guess. Or if it's a her. Jesus is like eating everything in sight. And these are the special brownies right here. Oh, this is pretty. Look at this. And this is from the catering of Monica and Auntie Jenny. Somebody took it down and walked out with it. Josh has it. Right there. Huh? Wait, look what?
You made it. I didn't have it.
He's not picky.
So this is Auntie Jenny. She taught me how to make tamales. This is Cousin Monica, the doctor. I don't care what you say, you're a doctor, as far as I care. That's what my mom used to call you. A doctor! And this is how I'm doing it. I'm picking out the beans so I can enjoy the rice and beans. And I'll have my belly ache. Ryan, we're nice till there's a contest. We're nice no longer.
Rough estimate and say like 88, 90. Because there's like there's 8 at the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? And then I'm going by like levels. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like kinda like bottles.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
10-ish to be
9. 9 times 8 is 72.
I'm gonna say 88. It's close,
put,
right?
Put 81 for me.
Okay.
What do you put for yours?
88.
I put 81 for 18 backwards.
Oh, that's smart.
That was my theory, but you might be, it might have more. What do we win, the gumballs? I want no damn gumballs, I want money. I want money. George just went to go check on Joe because he's laying in the back seat of the car because he doesn't feel well. What do you put?
36.
Random. We did it like bottles.
We did do it like bottles.
This is my sister's contribution. It's a cake made from diapers. It's pretty though. Mm-hmm. Took a lot of time, I'm sure. I like the new background thing, man.
I thought you were going to come in today, Obi, because...
No, I'll be here.
Oh.
Which is the easiest way to get there, Josh? This way?
He's right there. You can sit from here.
So we're going to go check on Joe because he's sleeping in the truck. Because he doesn't feel well. And we have to wear these things and we can't say this one word. Give me yours, Joshua.
I'm giving mine to Jada.
We can't say the word baby. And they're trying to trick you into saying like baby shower or stuff like that. Then they had some gumballs that we had to guess. So Jada count the bottom layer of the gumballs and she got 8. And then we counted up like 9 or 10 rows. We did it totally like when we're packing bottles. So I put 81 for the reverse of 18 because 18 was my mom's lucky number. Jada put 88. Joshua put 36.
Nailed it.
Jory put 43.
Double nailed it.
Derek Jr. put 150.
Triple nailed it.
So let's check on Joe. We're just checking on you, babe.
Okay.
Huh? You don't look okay.
You want a water? Let me get you a water.
Yeah. Want some cold water, babe? Are you just like sweating it out? You don't want to go sit in there? No?
Boring.
It's boring?
Yeah.
Okay. Just don't let nobody come and murder you out here. Okay. Remember, you're black and this is Hispanic town. And you're black. No, they start no gimmick under this foolish one here, but don't say baby. I'm ready to go. I already ate.
Because he works with the Avengers, but then again, he does kill
them. This.
That was so annoying though. I couldn't have just go buy an axe and cut down the trees and be done with it.
Yeah. Like get a little weak over there.
Mm-hmm. Are they like fighting aliens?
Okay.
Okay.
When's the win?
We'll take a default win any day. They had,
hey,
Derek, it's not fair, they had like a bajillion kids. So Jada won because, I'll tell you guys in the car.
Vlogging your sister next to you. Get it!
Yeah, Tracy.
Yes!
That hoe was trying to steal Jada's gift.
Yeah! She was super pissed!
Yeah!
I wasn't.
So this is what happened. They had this stupid game where they give you a chain
so
with a stupid binky or and a pin or whatever on it, and you can't say the word baby. So that's like the hardest thing to not say the word baby, because there was a bunch of babies there. So whenever you got up and they were in your way, we'd say, excuse me, baby, right? So then you lose your stuff. So then this one girl, she was just like, she was playing the game super hard. We weren't even playing the game super hard, right? She was playing it. So she went and she took away Jada's two chains because Jada had hers and Joe's because Joe went to sleep in the truck. So we got PO'd. And when Drew got there, Jada went back to the table with Drew and they stole two more off the table, off the original table. So we were back to square one. And all of us kept saying baby. Even Jory kept saying, they have the baby from the Game of Thrones. We kept saying baby shower. We said, I was talking to my cousin Monica. I'm like, yeah, when your brother Chalito was a baby, I used to babysit him. God, how many times did I not say baby? Like 17 still talking to Monica. And Monica's like, I hear you, but I'm not stealing it. And so we're like really, really mad at this woman. So she leaves with her husband and her 1,000,001 kids, and she gave all her chains to this one chick at that table who had already won a prize.
That chick is the one who has 1,000,001 kids. She didn't bring no kids, it was just her.
Okay. So she won because of all these 1,000,001 kids. Mm-hmm. Okay. So anyways, my sister is already steaming because apparently when my sister came to the bridal shower, they made a wedding gown out of paper or something. My sister says hers was totally the best, but they cheated to have the other side of the family win. And my sister is still fuming over that from what, 2 years ago, Jada?
Yeah.
And so,
was it 2 years?
We all decided, it was last year that she had her wedding, right?
Yeah.
So we all decided that we were gonna give Jada our chains at the appropriate time. We didn't want to give her all of them in advance, because if she said the word baby, we were screwed. They would have taken it all. So we all hid ours, and then at the appropriate time we gave it to her, and she hid it under her sleeve so nobody knew how much she had. So if she said the word baby, they would get the one around her neck, and that's it. And so I got up to go get some sandwiches, and a little baby came to trip me, and I said, excuse me, baby, I think the mom set it up. I mean, we're vicious at these things, okay? That's why we don't go to these things. And I said, excuse me, baby, and mom was like, give me your chain. I'm like, what chain, B-word? I don't have no chain. Look, I'm free, baby, baby, baby. And I kept saying,
yeah, mom did say that. She's like, baby, baby.
And I said, baby. I said, baby, the other white meat. Austin Powers reference. And so the girl that won the In-N-Out already, what did she win that off of? What game did she win that from?
That? It was either the
Roy won the counting.
The crossword.
No, it was none of those. No, it was none of those.
On the
what
right
was the first one that we played? The how much it cost.
Oh, okay. They brought you some baby stuff. There we go, baby. And you're supposed to guess how much they cost. And I said $25 and it was $32 and she got like $31 and something cents. So she won it fair and square. She knows the price of those things. She had 1,000,001 kids. Right. She should bloody know. My baby is 21.
Okay. Not 21,
she's 21.
Well, she's 20. She's going to be 21 this time. Oh, God.
Oh,
God.
Oh, Lord.
Look at this, guys. Oh, no.
I was hoping this wouldn't be here when we were doing that.
Oh, no, Mrs. Maddox. No. So back to the story at hand. My Aunt Jenny came later and said the girl turned in her little binkies. And she's like, I won. I know I won. And then Jada showed up like, bam, in your face. So Jada won. And she said, oh, they gave it all to her. I'm like, no, we didn't. We all said baby, and she snatched it.
We all sacrificed. I said baby. It was beautiful, man. There should have been like music in the background.
And slow motion and everything else. And my aunt was just laughing because my aunt wanted us to win for a change. You know, we were the black table as usual. It's always some kind of, there's always Hispanics at this stuff because Marceli's husband is Salvadorian.
Black.
So it's like a bunch of loaded, just Hispanics. And then we got the black like table, the ghetto table. Okay. Ghetto fabulous.
You know, it's bad traffic in the carpool way.
Anyways,
right?
We're going to go talk foolishness from now till we get out of this traffic.
All right, I'm hyped up on sugar so I can talk for a while.
Splash?
Yeah.